This mini split air conditioner is showing an F1 error code on the display, which the customer has told me. I will turn on the circuit. I have powered on the circuit board. The LED lights on the circuit board are not glowing right now. I will watch the LED 1 and 2 carefully to see whether the fault is shown instantly or after some time. I have passed electricity through the circuit board. The indoor unit has started to work. Now the error has not shown on the circuit board instantly, but is shown almost after 1 to 2 minutes. After this, LED 1 and 2 started to blink together. I have also heard a weird sound from the circuit board. Then, the error code on the outdoor board started to blink. If the IPM short circuits, the error code on the board is shown directly when it is turned on. Also, if some other component in the circuit is bad, it will show the problem of F1. The F1 error code has also started to show on the display of the air conditioner as well. The LEDs 1 and 2 on the circuit board are still blinking. I will now test the voltages of the circuit board. I will check the voltages on its IPM. I am attaching the multimeter probes with the negative and positive IPM pins. 296 volts are passing through the negative and the positive pins of the IPM. Next, I will see the voltages on the U pin of the IPM. We should get 15 volts on this pin. The same 296 volts are passing on the V pin as well. Let's check the next pin. 296 volts are passing through the W pin as well, which means that the IPM is problematic. Now, I will cut the electricity from the circuit board and then test it. I will test the IGBT to see whether it is short-circuited or not. I am checking it on diode mode. The IGBT of this circuit board is fine. I will test the diode of this circuit board as well because 300 volts were passing across 3-phase pins. I have changed the polarity of the probes. The diode's value is good, which means the diode is also fine. So, this means the IPM could be short-circuited. I have placed one probe at negative and the other at positive pins. See, it is showing zero voltage drop. This means one of the diodes of the IPM is short-circuited. Let's check the U, V, and W pins of the IPM. The W pin is also short-circuited. The U and V pins are fine. Now, here we learn that the microcontroller sometimes does not detect the fault, because if the company has not programmed it for quick fault testing. Otherwise, it will test the circuit board and then tell the fault as an error code. The microcontroller in this circuit board tested the circuit board, and then it showed the F1 error code. I will now start desoldering the IPM. I am using the soldering iron and the heat gun to heat the pins. This way, the pins will heat up quickly, and the IPM will be removed. I always use this technique. Now, I will pull the IPM with the tweezer. One side of the IPM pins has come out. I will remove the pins on the other side of IPM with the same method. The pins of the IPM have loosened and have come out of the board by pulling it. I will now clean the solder from the holes in the IPM traces. For that, I will add solder to these traces. This will make the sucking of excess solder easy. I will suck the solder individually, and each hole of the trace has started to clean. I will do the same on the other side of the hole traces. All the holes are empty from the solder now. I have installed the new IPM inside the board, but never solder the IPM directly. I always tell you in my videos, I have not soldered the IPM. Put the thermal paste on the IPM. However, the thermal paste is present on the heat sink. Then, very carefully place the circuit board on the heat sink. Take care that the IPM may not fall while placing the board. It has been placed on the heat sink. First of all, I will tighten the screws of the IPM, which will tighten the IPM with the heat sink. Now, I will solder the IPM by applying soldering paste to the pins. Always use soldering flux, which makes the soldering easier. I have attached the circuit board with the indoor unit. I will power on the circuit board. The circuit board has turned on. I will wait for a few seconds and see whether the compressor works or not. The compressor has started to work. All the LED lights started to blink on the circuit board. This means that I have comfortably fixed the F1 error from this air conditioning unit. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch the next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.